Welcome to the first of what I hope to be is a mini in a series of getting to know Providence. And we hope that those of you out there that maybe have deanery age kids or high school age kids, or maybe you are a graduate of Providence, you can get to know a little bit more about Providence High School through the eyes of people who work, teach, coach at Providence. And so today I'm joined for our first episode by theology teacher extraordinaire, Mr. Bart Makowsky.
Well, that's a nice introduction. So it's good to actually see face here today. This homebound stuff is not easy for anybody, I'm sure. So it's nice to see a friendly face and get to talk to somebody from school today. So
it is. That was really the, and you know, we got to give credit to Steve Bile for kind of starting all this. And I have kind of piggybacked on what he's doing. I had to call him just to make sure I didn't offend him if we did stuff like this. And he was like, I don't care, which I knew would be the answer. But we just want to have some fun and keep those connections going and figure out a way to get not only our scholastic content once we get back to school after our, what do we call those days? Our those days off that we get, our flex days that we get next week. But then be able to still deliver some of the things, you know, I can't be out at the schools talking to kids. So to be out, to be able to, just deliver some good news about what we have going on at Providence.
Oh, sure, sure.
So Bart, how long have you been teaching at Providence?
This is my 14th year. When I started, I was staying home with my kids for a couple of years out of a corporate gig I had been working. And when my daughter Maria started kindergarten, I happened to be at a ball game and ran into Carrie Gerber. Her son was playing soccer all those years ago at the time. And she asked me about subbing. And so I started subbing, and the first couple of years during that subbing, I did some long-term stints for a couple of the theology teachers, and that kind of grew into getting hired full-time into the theology department.
Okay. So tell us about some of the classes that you currently teach.
Okay. I teach at the senior level. The first semester is History of the Catholic Church. And we kind of look at, start a little bit with Adam and Eve and how what God intends for all of us, and then grow through those early years of the church, growing out of the apostles and Pentecost. We kind of hit some of the highlights. Hard to cover everything in one semester, but we kind of hit some of the major things, and especially spend some time with the church in the United States toward the end of the year, on how that church grew a tremendous amount through immigration and what that Catholic experience was like during a lot of that, and then kind of finish that first semester course up at the end of the year looking at the Industrial Revolution and the impact that had on workers, because that's really where Catholic social teaching begins, and that's our second semester course. So it kind of segues then into the second semester where we look at Catholic social teaching, the seven themes that the U.S. bishops have given us, a lot of the documents from the popes and the bishops in all of that. And really, to me, it's kind of that last class on the way out the door where we talk about, we've learned these things over so many years. Now, how are we going to live this out in the world? And so it's kind of that last chance to kind of instill that as they go out there about what it really means to live that stuff out.
Absolutely. And really, everything that we do at Providence, whether it's in a science class, a math class, with athletics, but certainly with your classes, working with campus ministry, really all about making disciples and just putting better people out into the world.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. It's definitely about wanting them to internalize this material, not just learn it as academic material, but really internalize it as a way of life.
Sure.
So that, that character grows, and then they go out and live that out on a daily basis. We talk a lot sometimes about what it means when St. Francis was credited with saying, preach the gospel always, when necessary, use words, that our actions are going to say a lot more about what we believe than just our words. So we got to back it up with those actions.
Wow, that's I like that. Talk to us about how the service hour requirement at Providence coincides, that kind of gives the students a more concrete, visible way to kind of back up some of the material that you're teaching them.
Oh, very much so, because it really, especially with the addition over the past few years of these contact hours, it really puts people, face to face in a way with people who are vulnerable in the world. We talk a lot about one of those themes is the option for the poor and the vulnerable, but even back to roots of social justice teaching in the Old Testament, where there was a special concern for the vulnerable, as they would have defined them at that time, the poor, the widow, you know, the stranger in a strange land, the immigrant, the traveler. But it's a way to really help people, you know, kind of see that there's a reality. All this is not just something we talk about, but it is a way of life. And those service hours really kind of get them into the habit of living this out on a day-to-day basis, kind of put some flesh on the bones, I guess, of the things we're teaching.
Absolutely. That's terrific. Take us through, you know, at Providence, our students have to have theology all 4 years.
Yeah.
Take us through kind of the curriculum, guide us through, you know, a student comes in as a freshman, what those classes look like all the way through to those senior level classes with you.
All right. Let me get that pulled up here again so I can take a look at, give them the correct names here. Freshman year, they're really kind of looking at, they start looking at some scripture. What do we know about Jesus from looking at scripture? So kind of some Old and New Testament, the buildup of all that. So it's a little scripture based. And then really focusing in on who is Jesus in our lives, historically, what he means for the church and creation. So they spend freshman year with that. Second semester, really kind of more, all these really revolve around, you know, as the center of our faith about Jesus. So sophomore year, they're going to be looking at the Paschal mystery, all about that work of salvation that Jesus accomplishes by coming here on earth and his suffering, death, and resurrection. And then we have how Christ's mission is carried on through the church, the role that the church plays in carrying that on kind of post-resurrection, post-ascension, the work then that the church has played over these 2,000 years and kind of continuing that mission. There's a class on the sacraments, so those very specific seven sacraments of the Catholic Church, learn more about each of one of those. And then life in Jesus, really kind of a bit of a morality course. What does it mean then for us to try to live out those things? So they really kind of ingrain again that idea of what it means to not just call myself a Christian, but what does it mean to live that out? And so that's kind of that 3 years. And each of those then are really kind of integrated with the service learning in a way that at the end of each of their academic years, there's some reflective work they have to do through their theology courses about the service learning for that year. And then the senior year kind of capstones it all about what that experience has been like over the years. So I'm trying to dovetail that together as well.
Okay. Awesome. Talk about how you know, in Spanish class, a lot of times we get maybe a negative attitude. You know, a student may, why do I need to know this? And so I spent a lot of time at the beginning of Spanish 1 convincing them that it's going to be great for their future economically and from a career standpoint. We would love it if they all went in and said, oh, I'm just intrinsically motivated to learn about another culture, another language. But so I got to have, so that's my hook. We would love it if all of our kids sat down at our, you know, whether it's freshman through senior, and sat down in your desk and said, I'm just so on fire with Jesus. Teach me all about him. I can't wait to hear about him. But that's not quite reality all the time. So how do you go about motivating kids to want to learn more about Jesus and their faith, and even more importantly, carrying out their faith?
Well, I think a lot of what I try to do, a lot of what other teachers, I know you try to do this as well, is really kind of model that faith. I think the more they can see positive examples of people living that out and making that an important part of their life, that's a big help. The first Friday of every month, we have adoration at Providence. So we talk about what that means to us, that Jesus is present there in the Eucharist, and we spend some time down there in adoration. Try to show a lot of basic ways that this can be part of our life, and overall really trying to kind of build that character to help people understand the, you know, what it means to be a good person, to make good choices. I know I watched the interview yesterday with Coach McDonald that Steve Bile did, and he talked about one of his goals for the program being character, you know, those choices you make when people aren't watching. And that's really, I think, what a lot of this learning about Jesus is about, having that developed character, how to be a better person in the world, how to be somebody that looks at the needs of others and not just my own. If anything, I think we're seeing, you know, we've talked a lot in social justice about the common good this year. Man, that's what all of this kind of staying at home and social distancing and all that kind of stuff has all been about, looking at the needs of others compared to mine. I would much sooner be out doing things with other people, but that's not the role I have to play right now, is to kind of stay away and to help this thing run its course. So it's really about, you know, again, helping them understand that this is something that they can integrate into their lives so that, you know, they can live a richer and fuller life.
Important is to help the students understand the importance of faith in our life. And you were saying we do that mostly just through our own examples of the adults in the building.
Yes, definitely. I think the single biggest way to kind of help them in that is to model that for them. And try very hard as we learn these different things over the years to really kind of apply that to where they are in life today, to help them see some kind of practical application of the things they learn. Especially try to do that with Catholic Church history. You know, a lot of things like, well, why is the Mass the way it is today? And we looked at what some of that early liturgy looked like. So anytime we can kind of take that and make it more applicable to their lives today as well, I think that really helps them see the point in doing it, and kind of helps them internalize that a little bit more, and kind of help them realize, you know, the richer nature, the fuller nature their life can have when that's a part of it.
Great. Talk about your own, you know, you're at, seems like every Providence event, you go on senior retreat sometimes twice a year. You're very involved in Providence, and more importantly, I believe for you probably, the in the students' lives. You're very much intertwined with everything they do, both at school, extracurricularly, and in their faith life. Talk about why that's so important for you.
Providence has just been a huge part of my life all along. My brother and sister, 8 and 10 years older than I am. So when they were in Providence, gosh, I guess my brother, if he would have started at 14, I would have been about 4. So there's really not a time that I don't remember going to Providence and that being an enormous part of my life. And so when I had the chance to kind of come back there, where, you know, I went there as a student myself, graduated in 87, kind of kept up with athletics and those kind of things. But the chance to come back there and work and be a part of it on a day-to-day basis has been an enormous blessing in my life. And it really is the relationship part of it to me. You know, if you really want to impact kids and kind of get them off to a good start in life, then it is about building those relationships, letting them know that there are people who care about them and are, you know, and are there for them. And I think just kind of being present is a big way to do that. So definitely, you know, kind of going stir crazy, not being able to go to all of those events right now. So I'm hoping against hope that we can have a few by the end of the school year, that we'll get back there in early May and can start getting some of those things going again.
Absolutely. I would love nothing more to be back in school on May 4th or whatever that Monday is.
All right.
Real quick, give us just a couple things through this. You know, I think one of the common themes we've heard everybody is, you know, things we took for granted that now are taken from us. So give us three things that have really hit home for you, of things that Bart Makowsky took this for granted, and you know, you realize how precious these things are.
Well, certainly just one of the huge things is the ability to go to Mass, you know, either during the week or on a Sunday, and just kind of be there present in God's house. You know, you never really conceive of a time where that's not going to be available to you. I mean, you know, a lot of these things that we're doing, probably we haven't seen since World War II, and that wouldn't even have been one of those. I mean, people still would have been able, you know, we weren't rationing Mass during World War II, and that's all, you know, that's one of the huge things. You know, just face-to-face human interaction. I mean, I've still got that with my family, thank God, but just, you know, to be able to do that with other people, co-workers, students, all those kinds of things you just kind of take for granted, especially as you get toward the end of the school year. You know, you're in such a routine there, you just expect that to continue to the end. And then very abruptly, you know, you and I both worked that senior retreat together, and certainly leaving on that Tuesday, I did not imagine that would be the last time I'd see, you know, the kids that weren't with us for another 5 or 6 weeks playing that everyday contact as well.
Well, thanks so much for spending a little bit of time with us.
Oh, glad to.